I'm Claude Barrera. I'm the head of technical strategy for IBM Storage within Systems Group. I wouldn't say serious technical hurdles, but there certainly is work to do. So let me sort of reflect on what I think the state of play is. So rather than starting with the thread of metadata, let's start with the thread of data governance. And there is an increasing awareness that we have too much data, we know too little about it, and there are too many regulations and obligations of people who play the custodian role to simply say, well, you know, it arrived and with some relatively simple set of permissions and authorizations, whatever anybody wants to do must be okay. So, for example, you see the rise of GDPR in the EU, where there are some rather important regulations about what can and cannot be done with personal information and what kind of authorization must be obtained and kept, and what happens when authorization is withdrawn. So, how do you add those kinds of requirements into the data governance world? Well, in the structured data world, the answers are fairly good. I mean, I wouldn't call it perfect, and I wouldn't say a lot of these technologies are completely deployed or widely deployed, but they do exist. So things like the Guardium technology within IBM and IBM Data Catalog, and if you want to do this in a cloud environment, we have cloud brokerage services so that your data catalog can span multiple clouds, and you can sort of figure out that this data came from here and went to there, and here are the database schema associated with that data. And by looking at schema, you can take steps to say, well, is there personal data in there? Is there data that can't cross a geo boundary? You know, what obligations do I have? For unstructured data, it's a much worse problem. Unstructured data comes in from all over the place. There might be almost no metadata other than file create date. Things like provenance and guarantees of immutability since the original creator created the stuff. We're just on the cusp of, you know, people putting somebody's head on some other figure in a video and making it look awfully real. So there will be big demands for this data governance role. The technologies for database, pretty much in place, and companies like IBM can help clients with that. For unstructured data that exists in file and object stores, it's a much harder problem. So the main advance that we have coming, which has been demoed by IBM Research in a project called MetaOcean, is simply the idea of creating a governance layer, not in the data path, but there's a alerting mechanism or an event mechanism that says a new file was created, a file was updated, a file is scheduled for deletion, you know, the kinds of events that govern the life cycle of files and objects, and a metadata-based layer that is augmented with Watson Analytics, which knows how to do deep inspection on a whole bunch of different file types, and in combination with our data catalog and our brokerage service, we can collect information about what's where, what's inside the files, and associate business rules that say personal data stays within my geo, and here are the levels of authorization required before data of this type gets deleted. So we can protect from things that show up that shouldn't be in our environment, things that have a useful purpose for some period of time and should be expired after that. And just sort of accidental, I didn't know I wasn't supposed to, but I copied this thing to a cloud which happens to be in some other geography, and you know, oops, that wasn't such a good thing. So this idea of deep analytics to build richer and richer metadata, not just, you know, here's the date the file arrived and when it was created, but information about its content and the rules for its use, that's the objective of MetaOcean. I think both models exist, but at scale, the second model you refer to with a common, you know, centralized environment is really the only one that works. You can't scan object stores and file systems at big scale to obtain information that you're looking for a particular object. From a strategy standpoint, we look carefully at all the products. Protect in particular, because it houses large capacities and it becomes sort of a funnel for data as it ages. That's sort of one side of it, and the idea of collecting rich metadata as part of the Protect activity as we ingest copies to be for backup purposes or archival purposes into Protect. Build metadata around it, and then retrievals from archive then become a metadata search question. I go essentially through the metadata looking for the things I want, and I don't do big retrievals until I really have a beat on what I'm after. The MetaOcean thing is sort of complementary to that. It really lives in an active data environment, and there's still a bit of an ongoing debate about, in really big cloud scale things, maybe the notion of backup and archive doesn't really exist anymore. Maybe there's the giant big sea of data, and some of it is colder than other, but there's really only one access method into this stuff. And then above that, you have the data store, which is feeding the GPUs directly. So in that case, sort of a two-tier model. Data never really becomes inactive, but there's really high performance and low cost optimization. And then the trick is moving data up and down in that hierarchy according to the workload being presented. Well, in fact, we do exactly those things. The research, this is basically research activity at the moment, primarily out of Haifa and Zurich, but the one of the insertion points for something like Watson is in the caching algorithms. So when you do retrieves out of the slow store and decide what to kick out, you know, the historical caching that was developed for transaction processing was LRU, and then there was ARC caching, but fundamentally it was a view of what's hot right now, what's cold in the cache, kick it out. The newer idea around these, you know, massive stores is a proactive view of what data is likely to be needed in the next minute, in the next hour, in the, you know, whatever. And the insights that you can create by making a Watson engine aware of data access patterns to us seem very promising. And there may be multiple rule types by industry, but the notion of inserting Watson and allowing it to learn what this customer with their workload against this data set, perhaps varying by day or by end of the month, or but what prefetches should be staged up, and what does the nature of the prefetch architecture actually look like? But it's not going to be as simple as LRU anymore. There's going to have to be deeper insight into, here's the workload that I see coming, here's what I've got, here's how I've seen this behavior work in the past, and there won't be a human that designs the algorithm. It will be dynamic. On the question of, you know, what the rules are about where things can go and what can be done with them, ultimately it starts with business rules and policies that are set by people that speak business terms, and then those have to be enforced, and they have to be enforced across the entire life cycle and on whichever cloud things go to. Part of the selection of which cloud should this data be allowed to go to must be determined by what services are offered by that cloud, what protections, what geolocations, all the aspects of data governance must be understood on the terms of, this is the cloud provider, he's going to be the service provider, now what is this a match for what our rules are? In the world of database, that today is set up largely statically. So I define a database, I have a workflow that says I take backups, I take snapshots, I do archival functions, and there's a run book that defines where those things go. And inspection by humans of, you know, this is it and this were the rules is sort of where things are at the moment. We have to do more in terms of automation because, particularly in the unstructured data world, the capacities are too big and the data is too obscure for individual humans to say, well, a single run book will just take care of everything that comes in from the big wide world.